سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم لا سهل لما جعلته سهلا وتجعل حزنا والصعب إذا مشيت سهلا. اللهم آمين. As my brother mentioned, that tomorrow is the day of Arafa, and the day of Arafa is a day that we should all be preparing for and ready and looking forward to. وَشَاهِدٍ وَمَشْهُودٍ. As Allah indicated in the Quran, that this is the day that will be witnessed by the Malaika when Allah comes down to the lower sky and will be saying to the Malaika, وَيُبَاهِي بِكُمْ مَلَائِكَتَهُ. Allah will be proudly mentioning to the Malaika what we are be doing on the mountain of Arafah. And the word Yubahi will be showing off of what the Malaika will be saying to the Malaika. These are the ones whom, when you say, when I created Adam, أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَاءَ وَنَحْنُ نُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِكَ وَنُقَدِّسُ لَكَ. Allah Azza will be saying, the Malaika, these are the, my servants, have stood on the mountain of Arafah with humiliation, with hopes and rahmah from Allah Azza wa Jalla. So the day of Arafah is indeed the day of maghfirah and itq from the Niran. Throughout the month of Ramadan, we worked hard throughout the 30 days of fast and the 30 days of qiyam, hoping that Allah will give us the salvation from the hellfire. And ما من يوم, no days of the whole year, يعتق الله عز وجل, Allah will be setting people free from the hellfire like the day of Arafah. Not even Laylatul Qadr. So there is a chance for us that is specified and known when it is, which is tomorrow, to be surrendering to Allah عز وجل and to submit to His will and to ask Him for the maghfirah and the itq from the Niran. This should be the ultimate goal for us. This should be the ultimate dua to Allah Azza wa Jalla. مَنْ جَاءَ بِالْحَسَنَةِ فَلَهُ خَيْرٌ مِنْهَا وَهُمْ مِنْ فَزَعٍ يَوْمَئِذٍ آمِنُونَ وَمَنْ جَاءَ بِالسَّيِّئَةِ فَكُبَّتْ وُجُوهُهُمْ فِي النَّارِ هَلْ تُجْزَوْنَ إِلَّا مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. The Jannah is haq and the Nar is haq. Allah described that to us in the Quran in Surah Al-A'raf when He said, when the people of Al-Jannah will be saying to the people of the fire, إِنَّا قَدْ وَجَدَنَا مَا وَعَدَنَا رَبُّنَا حَقًّا فَهَلْ وَجَدْتُمْ مَا وَعَدَ رَبُّكُمْ حَقًّا قَالُ نَعَمْ فَأَذَّنَ بَيْنَهُمْ مُؤَذِّنَ اللَّعْنَةُ اللَّهِ عَلَى الظَّالِمِينَ. When in the day of judgment, the people of the Jannah, when they are in Al-Jannah, when they are entertained with the attractions of Al-Jannah, when they are seeing the rivers of Al-Jannah, when they are, you know, enjoying the fruits of Al-Jannah, when they are drinking from Al-Hawd al-Kawthar, when they are settled, when they are satisfied, when they are happy, they will be calling among the people of the hellfire, we have found what Allah has promised us through His prophets and the scripts, haq. Did you find what you were promised, haq? They would say, na'am. Only one word, na'am, this is it. They cannot, you know, add any further. And then in return, Allah Azza wa Jalla described to us how the people of the hellfire, wal-iyadu billah, will be saying, وَنَادَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ أَصْحَابُ الْجَنَّةِ أَنْ أَفِيضُ عَلَيْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ أَوْ مِمَّا رَزَقَكُمُ اللَّهِ قالوا إن الله حرمهما على الكافرين الذين اتخذوا دينهم لهوا ولعبا وغرتهم الحياة الدنيا. Allah, they will, the people of the fire will be saying, pour unto us from what Allah Azza wa Jalla had given to you from the provisions of Al-Jannah. They will be saying to them simply, Allah have forbidden that unto you. Why? Because you have taken your life لهو ولعب. This is, you know, what we need to be mindful about. Many of us are living in lahu and la'ab, my brothers and sisters. We have taken this dunya for granted. We are only visitors. One day we will die. We don't know when that day will be coming to us. None of us denies this fact. From the rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jal, we are being given chances. One of them is indeed tomorrow. Do not miss it. Do whatever it takes so that you will be, you know, in this day, submitting to Allah Azza wa Jal and showing to Him the best of what you have. As Ibn Rajab indicated, that Allah Azza wa Jal will be looking at Tal'u ala the servants on the mountain of Arafah and will be forgiving to them. And he said also, will be the same for other people in Al-Ansar, in other parts of the world. That's why we all celebrate Eid after the day of Arafah, after Allah Azza wa Jal had granted the forgiveness to us. And when the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asked the Sahaba to be quiet and he talked to them on the day of Arafah, the eve of Arafah, he said to them, Allah Azza wa Jal had forgiven وَحَمِلَ التَّبِعَاتِ have also forgiven the sins of that we have done against others around us. And Umar al-Khattab said, Ya Rasulullah, ahadihi lana khasa, is the forgiveness and also forgiving the tabi'at, which are the things that we have done against others around us. Is it only inclusive to those who are around you, Rasulullah, because of your company, because we are with you in this Hajj? The Prophet ﷺ said, to you and to those who will be coming after you. So this is from the rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Let us tomorrow show Allah what will make him happy from us. Let us intend from tonight to do the siyam tomorrow, because the siyam of tomorrow will be kuffir sanatayn. This is, you know, a big chance, a big rahmah. We fast 30 days in Ramadan to gain the forgiveness. Now fasting one day will not be only forgiving to us all the sins of the year, will be forgiving to us this year, the year that has passed and the year to come. And also show Allah what will make him happy from you. Come to the masjid. There is, you know, nothing to prevent us from coming and doing i'tikaf as we have done it throughout the days of Ramadan. Leave the dunya behind you. Come to Allah Azza wa Jal. Ignore all the dunya, as the hajjis have left their money, their businesses, everything in the dunya, and they come to Allah Azza wa Jal, shu'than ghubran, you know, with humiliation, with you know, all the conditions that will make Allah look at them with the eyes of mercy. Do the same. If you want to gain the maghfirah, you want to gain the rahmah, well, let's copy those who are standing on the mountain of Arafah. Let's be like them in a state of humiliation. Let's forget about the whole world for 24, for a few hours from, you know, in the day of Arafah. And let also do the things that will make Allah happy from us. Do a sadaqah in this day that will make Allah happy with you. Do an act of salat al-rahim that Allah will make Allah Azza happy with you. Do whatever Allah Azza will see you in a different way in that day, with a broken heart, with tears in the eyes. Come to him and gain this day. Nas'al Allah Azza wa Jal from his precious bounties and rahmat, that he will enable us, because it's only the rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jalla that would make it possible. He would make it possible for us to be from those who are able to gain the maghfira, the rahmah, the itq from niran, fa innahu ala kulli shay'in qadir. Jazakumullah khairan. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.